Hey guys, earlier tonight I sat down with George Makris to discuss some of the new cases we're launching here at CES. Why don't you take a look? I'm here with George Makris, product manager for cases and cooling. We've seen a lot of coverage so far at CES about the new cases, the Obsidian Series 250D and the new Graphite Series 730 and 760T. On the internet, I've found some questions out there. Do you mind answering a few of them for me?
Yeah, sure, let's go.
All right, so the first one we've seen here is, you know, why another full tower case? Isn't the industry going towards smaller cases?
Yeah, I think that the industry, or one part of the industry, is going towards smaller cases. We've seen mini ATX explode a lot. But the other thing we've seen a lot of is actually guys doing really big cool water cooling builds with, you know, quad crossfire or three-way SLI. And they're doing that whether they're doing mining for coins or whether they're doing gaming or whatever, or multi-monitor setups. We see a lot of that still, and there's a lot of traction there. So I don't think it's mutually exclusive. I don't think you have to do one or the other. I think you can do both. Mm-hmm. And that's why today we actually announced our smallest case ever, and again, one of our biggest cases ever.
Cool, cool. So another one is, you know, what's the difference between 730T and 760T?
That's a good question. The 760T has that full panel window. That's the biggest difference. It's a giant full panel window. The 730T has a steel side panel. There are two other small differences. There's a stealth optical drive cover on the 760T, so you don't have to see your Blu-ray drive cover. And there's also a fan speed toggle on the 760T that lets you turn your fans from 12 volt to 7 volt. But other than that, the cases are pretty much identical. Also, the 760T comes in white, whereas the 730T only comes in black.
Okay, and then what's the thinking behind the big side panel, big clear side panel on the 760T?
When we look online and, like, you know, post pictures of your rig threads, we see people that, like, take the side panel off and take a picture of that internal, and they want to show their cable routing prowess or the way they cleanly did their liquid cooling routing and the hard bends on the acrylic tubing and stuff like that. And they have to take the side panel off to show that off. So we thought, what if we could make that easier and just put that big window there? And we did a couple of tests and we looked at it and it looked really, really cool. So that's how we got there.
Okay, and then another one here I've got is, you know, what's the difference between the 760T and the Obsidian Series 750D?
The 750D and 760T have the same skeleton inside. They're basically the same chassis internally. The difference is that the cosmetic exterior is significantly different. For example, you have the swing out doors on the 760T and 730T, and LED fans, things like that. On the 750D, you have that aluminum fascia that all the Obsidian cases have, and that's the biggest difference, is a cosmetic difference. One other small difference is that the 750D can fit a 240 radiator on the bottom, whereas the 760 and 730 have only a single 120 mount down there.
Okay, okay. Another one we got here is, you know, why do we also create the 730T without the window side panel?
A lot of people wanted to be able to buy a full tower case that had a lot of features, like a true full tower with 9 slots and room for a 360 and all that stuff, but they didn't want to have $100 for that case. So when we looked at it, we said, well, you know, if we did it without this window, this giant window, we can make it a lot more affordable for people. So that's where the 730 came in. It's just to make it a much more reasonable price point.
Okay, and then so onto the 250D. What's the purpose of the Obsidian Series 250D?
The 250D is our first foray into mini ITX, and the goal behind it was to make a very easy to access mini ITX product, so that if someone had your standard mid tower case and they really wanted to build a mini ITX case, they could do it with as little pain as possible. And by that I mean, you know, right now you have to decide if you have to get a smaller CPU cooler, a smaller power supply, or, you know, other components, get rid of a hard drive or two, that type of stuff. So we looked at what are people putting in a standard mid tower case, and we wanted to make it possible to put that into a mini ITX case. So aside from buying a mini ITX board, you'd be able to use your standard, you know, Haswell processor or your standard video card, power supply, all that stuff you wouldn't have to rebuy. A lot of times when you get a small form factor, you have to start thinking about, you know, do I have to get a smaller CPU cooler? Do I have to get a smaller power supply? In this case, you don't. You can just get yourself the mini ITX motherboard and the 250D, put them both in your cart, check out, and then, you know, 3 days later, you're building that system.
Okay, and then a lot of people are wondering what you think about the Steambox.
I think Steambox is really interesting. I think it's going to take some traction before it's a widespread thing. I saw today there's 12 or 13 different guys that are announcing their different variants of them, and they're all over the place. Some guys just built it into like a standard kind of mini ITX case. Other guys have, you know, purpose-built proprietary stuff that's basically like a laptop with an aluminum wrapper on it. So, I mean, I think we see a lot of different things. I think we'll see how people end up using it and how well the execution is before it becomes like a standard living room system, and then we'll start talking about hardware. I kind of go the other way. I wouldn't rather be the first guy to have a Steambox to market. I kind of want to have a vibe for what people are actually doing with it and how they're using it, and then we can create the best version of that product. So I didn't want to race out to just launch something that I felt was kind of half done. And I think that some of these are really good that have come out, and others I just kind of think, you know, it was just a small PC that they put a Steam logo on.
All right, well, thanks for your time, George. If you guys have any more questions for George, here's how to get in touch with us.